They're like, if we get into social media, bloggers will begin to write about us and everything. I'm like, there are different platforms on social media, and it's very good to always put out your content so you also control the perception that people have, rather than leaving other people to talk about it.
Simon says.
It's the Simon Says podcast.
Like, because you started your own agency, so to speak, like recently,
yes.
Like, and you've done that. What do you think Kenyan businesses don't really understand on communicating their products or their services on social media? What do you think is the biggest issue that they get when they're actually making content on social media? What do you think?
I think they're afraid. Even like last year, when people don't understand something, they're afraid of it. And people even put everything in one box, social media, blogging. They're like, if we get into social media, bloggers will begin to write about us and everything. I'm like, there are different platforms on social media, and it's very good to always put out your content so you also control the perception that people have, rather than leaving other people to talk about it. And also it gives you an opportunity, a place where you can respond. But if you even look at last year when we were hit by COVID, one of the things that as a PR company we had to do is even simple things of training people on how to use Zoom. And
what?
People are so afraid of it. Yeah, so you tell people, no, just install it. They're not like, no, you come and train. So sometimes technology might seem very easy, but it's easy only when I guess you've used it. And a lot of times people are afraid of the things they don't know. And it's because you're pushing them out of their comfort zone. So yeah. My work as a PR person who uses social media a lot, I have to, in a nice way, take you out of your comfort zone, but then show you the benefits of social media. One of the benefits that I tell people is that everyone now has a phone. Almost everyone has a phone. Not everyone reads the newspaper, but everyone has a phone. So if you're trying to reach people, social media is one of the best ways. I discovered you on social media. Probably if you're in a newspaper, I would have never discovered you, because I don't buy an actual newspaper every single day. I buy it on some certain days of the week, and the rest of the times I read my stories from social media. And also a lot of times, also part of the reason why I don't buy the newspaper as much is because I already know the news for today. I see the stories on social media. So by the time you're giving me tomorrow's newspaper, it's stale news. I already know, like yesterday we watched a former CS with the by-elections going on slap someone.
Yeah.
I didn't have to wait for it the next day. I watched it a few minutes after it happened on Twitter. So,
Do you think now the mainstream media, like what you've talked about, because you've been in the mainstream media, you've been a business reporter, you've been a news anchor. Do you think then now, how has mainstream media had to adjust when you see that social media now has become the first responder? You know, radio used to do it. Radio is the one that used to go for the breaking news instantly, like so-and-so has passed, whatever. But how is now, when social media comes into prominence, how is now, what do you think that's now mainstream media has to do to adjust now to this?
So I in the last 5 years, or maybe even like Nation Group, which was one of the first guys, they quickly adjusted. And you can see in their business plan, a lot of now media houses have started putting up a big budget for social media, what they call digital. Nation was one of the first media houses who quickly even came up with a digital strategy. They even had a gentleman called, I think, Ian Fernandez, who was the head of digital. And then even people did not take digital as seriously as they should. Even now, a lot of companies are still not taking digital as seriously as they do, as they should. I see Citizen now have digital options. They have even some of their shows on ViuSasa. So they know not everyone has access to a TV, but with your phone, you can watch some of their loved shows on ViewSasa, mm-hmm. which also makes you want to watch Citizen more, and probably even end up buying a TV because I want to watch Citizen. So we have to be to catch up every day with our customers, say as even media and even our viewers, that they have changed. I don't necessarily sit these days and watch news, you know, from 9 to 9 p.m. Sometimes I'll record it to watch later. Sometimes, like today, I'll probably watch it on my way home. So I'll watch it on my phone. So they have to make sure even the content that they are putting up is phone friendly. A lot of them now have a whole department for digital. We see them also a lot on social media. They also
even
have
Twitter.
To break the news.
Twitter
they have
ads,
to break the news
ads, yeah.
Exactly. So now they're on Twitter. And the advantage is, talking again about, you know, when I'm talking to clients and convincing them and getting them out of their comfort zone, is what people don't realize is the digital world is another revenue source.
It's the Salmon Says Podcast.